Hello guys, PLC programming and automation. We continue from part 2, okay? If you check my previous video, I explained how to read the electrical drawing, okay? And we continue from part 2, okay? This document is about quotic machine, okay? Use this to coat a coated gum. Okay, if you want to coat your product, this machine is what we use. And this also document talk about the total capacity of the machine, and also it also talk about the power supply. And then the voltage, DC voltage also, then the kilowatt, okay. So like I said in my previous video, this is a legend abbreviation, which is very important for you as a technician. You must understand this, symbols, okay. There is a symbol here which I want to talk about, okay. This symbol, LCD, this symbol is LCD, okay. And I think also this is a relay box, okay. All right, and this guy also is a contactor, okay, contactor terminal. All right, so if you want to learn more, you can check my previous video. I explained these IC symbols already. Okay. So let's proceed. Okay. So this also, I think I talked about it, the document and then the installation and the placement monitor. And this guy also is the index pages. Okay, everything that is written here, you can find it in the document. Okay, so we try to go straight to the drawing. Okay, so this is the drawing, and this is the starting point. Okay, so if you can see, we have neutral line 1, line 2, line 3, then we have the PP, the P. Okay, which is the ground, earth. Okay, then it goes to a circuit breaker with a neutral. Okay, then from there to this LCD. Okay, then the LCD also distributes to the various places. Okay, so before this motor can work, let's look at this motor. Before it can work, let's check the component that needs to be closed before it can work. Okay, so we have this circuit breaker here. Okay, and this motor take life and then neutral. So if you read it to this place, you see that it have, it is a neutral line, this guy is a neutral line, and then this guy is a line, okay, a power line. And also this is also a contact which need to be closed. Okay, so if you want to find this contact, you need to check the number. Okay, you check the number, that is QF. Okay, and as I told you earlier in my previous video, you have something which you need to know. Okay, this I told you, the one there is a page number, and then the four is a column number. So you can look for this contact, and then you check also Okay, you can find this with the number. Okay, then if you scroll down, I have already show you guys also what this guy is. Okay, this guy is a thermostat. Okay, and it needs to be closed. So if you are troubleshooting, you troubleshoot from top to down. So this guy also, it's normally open and it close. Okay, so if this guy is closed or if it is open, there's no way the motor will receive voltage. Okay, so this is how you can also troubleshoot it. Okay, and the wire, the cable, the designer give you a number to locate it very easy. So this is the tag number which you can use to locate the cables. Okay, then this is the motor, and as I already show you, we have the first number there is what is the page number, and then the second and the third number there is the color number, the second is the motor. You see there is an M there. Okay, so basically this is how you can troubleshoot this ventilation motor. Okay, and let's see if we can also read this one. Okay, so this is also a contact that need to be closed, so you can locate them through this number. Okay, then this also is a circuit breaker. Okay, that need to be closed before this. So you see that line one, neutral, and then ground, and then neutral. So if this guy close, then there will be a current flow. Okay, the same as this, same as this. You cannot only on the contactor and then this guy will receive power. No, it's some component need to be also close before this guy. So this guy have line one and then neutral, then the ground. Okay, so how do we know this guy? We can see that there is a plus, plus, minus, minus. So it means that this item here produce a 24 volts. Okay, so all this get this 24 volts from here. Okay, then this LED light. Okay, all right, so this is also a switch box. Okay, switch box. And this 24 volt also it goes to this connectors. Okay, I will explain these guys in my previous in the next video. Okay, so if you check this guy, let me zoom it a little bit. We have a 6A, 6B, 6C, 6D. All these goes to this connection point. Then from there, it's distribute. Okay, so we'll get to know more about them. Okay. All right, so you see that this line. Okay, then it goes to the circuit breaker, then it goes to this transformer. Okay, this transformer, and then the transformer give out a single volt. Okay, then it come out 230 volt. Okay. All right, so this is also the PLC. Okay, then we have the CPU, which is this CPU. Then we have Ethernet port. So you see that we have BA. Okay, BA. Okay, then we also have digital input, okay, and digital output. Then we have analog input and analog output. Okay, so this is the output, and I show you something there. See this? Okay, so if you go back, like I said, I will explain this in my next video, but let me just explain it to you. So this connection or the connectors, you can see them from the PLC. okay, so it's like the PLC output. Okay, the input and then the output of the PLC. Right, so this is about the PLC. So you know that the designer had a PLC in the control cabinet. Okay, and also these are the Ethernet connector. Okay, the Ethernet port. Okay, and this Ethernet port, it need to power it. Okay, and the power section, you can see that it's the 6C that they take the power from. Okay, so it's a positive and then negative. Okay, then we go on and then explain this guy also is a contactor, and where can we locate it? We can locate it on page 122, column 5. Okay, so you need to understand all this as a technician. Okay, then you also need to know this symbol. And I have explained them already, but this, it comes with auxiliary contact. Okay, it comes with auxiliary contact, right? Come with auxiliary contact. So this circuit breaker, okay, they all come with auxiliary contact. Then we have a contactor. Where can we locate it? We can locate it page 23, column 7. Okay, and this Omron AC drive. Okay, Omron AC drive. Where can we locate it? Let's zoom in a little bit, and then we see we can locate this. Okay, let me clean this. We can locate it page 24, column 1. This can be located where? We can locate it page 100, column 7, which is a contactor, that is KM7. Then we have also KM7. Okay, KM7, but the difference is also the page where you can locate it. Okay, so this guy will power the brick, then the AC drive also will power this 11 kilowatt motor, and then another AC drive will also power 1.2 1.1 kilowatt, okay, motor. Okay, and this contactor also will power 4 kilowatt motor. All right, so we also have this. Okay, that is, you can find it on what page? Page 12, column 1. Okay, you can find this circuit breaker. Okay, this circuit breaker, then the tag number, cable number. This also a contactor called a contactor contact, which can be located on page 100, column 8. Okay, then this is a terminal block. Okay, this motor also, you can find it page 12, column 1. Okay, page 12, column 3, you can find this one also. Okay, then this also is normally open and then normally close contact. It can be a switch. Okay, so you have to locate it and find where it is. Then this also a circuit breaker. Okay, right. Okay, then this also, we have a circuit breaker here, a circuit breaker here also. Okay, this a circuit breaker, this a circuit breaker, this a circuit breaker. Okay, so this circuit breaker, like I said, it comes with auxiliary contact. Okay, you see there is some differences. Okay, normally open, normally open, but this guy here come with normally closed and then normally open. This also come with normally closed, normally open. This one normally open, normally open. Okay, so you have to take note of them. You have to understand how it works before you can troubleshoot. Okay, so this also the contactor. So the contactor coil, you see, they are showing it here. Okay, sometimes it's the software will do that itself. Okay, because the designer use implant software. Okay, okay, so this is also an element. Okay, this can be neither thermocouple. Okay, then this motor and this also can be, but if you look at I think, let me zoom it, see that it's 400 watts, so it's a heating element. Okay, okay, heating element. Okay, this one also is a heating element. Okay, then this motor also is being powered. Okay, the cable numbers. Okay, then we continue. Okay, then this one. Okay, then this one, you already know them. Okay, then this also AC drive. Okay, and it power this motor. Okay, so guys, we'll continue in my next video. If you find this video very helpful, kindly help me by sharing and subscribing. Okay, with doing that, you are supporting me. Okay, so you see, I show you what this guy is. So if you know what this guy is, kindly write it in the comment section. Okay.